Oh, we make money. We made big money, boys. This is from experience. I'm going to tell you, this is perfect quantity and 10% more speed. We made money, boys. We made. This is great for the video. This is extremely expensive. So, this is very expensive. This is more than 25 divine orbs. Hello, my boys. Here is another reminder for making money in the Affliction League. It's about those Val Temple maps, which are pesky red maps, that I have a guide on it and I explain how to set up your atlas. We will do two maps so you can see how much profit you make, because they are very profitable. So the moment I started farming them, roughly with the corrupted blood jewels and double corrupted items, I got closer to 60 divine orbs. And this I got in 2 days from running Val Temple maps. Also, it's important to know that this has synergy with the Wildwood mechanic, because the Wandering Path, you get also much more drops. But if your build it cannot handle Wildwood mechanic, because the monsters get very hard at some points, you can skip it and you still make profit. This is great. Again, for new players, if you don't know it, I have the guide. Elenium, you know, it's on my channel.
It lasts longer, which is pretty nice.
Let's see if I missed something. Okay, you got the idea. You watch it here, Koval Temple Mass, how to farm them for maximum profit, okay? This is very profitable. Very profitable. If you followed me since last league, you know that I sold items for 200 divine orbs, 250 double corrupted items. Some items can be insanely expensive. Yeah, so yeah, let's jump into it. I'm gonna put a map, which, by the way, you don't care about these modifiers because they get changed because of the atlas setup. To understand the atlas setup, you need to watch the guide on how to set up. This is an excellent farming method. Not only that it's fun, it's also great, you make a lot of profit. We will run two maps and you will see how much money we make. You know, it's best to see for yourself, you know, better than talking. Also, you get, I need to remind you, you all get the special elder maps from divination cards and you get them a lot. So this one I got from the divination card, which is this one, elder occupied map. And I turned them in and you got shit ton of maps. Yeah, you get a lot of, you get also special essences. Which I sell them in bulk. I hoard multiple ones and I sell them in bulk. Also, because we're running delirium, you get delirium orbs. Very nice. I need to check something. Yeah, we're getting delirium orbs. Now let's open one and see how it goes. Okay, boys, once inside, you can go in the league mechanic or you can skip it, depending on your build. Okay, so this map is profitable even if you skip the league mechanic. I will do it, but again, if you don't like the juiced monsters, you can skip it. No problem. A lot of people go for blue juice because makes the monsters drop a lot of currency. I like it also. Blue juice, I must admit, blue juice is the best. Wisp, blue wisps. I call it juice because it juices the map. Oh, this was luck, boys. Don't count this. It's just me being lucky, you know. Let me check the price. Yeah, 1.4 divine orbs. This I love about totems. You put your totems and you stay in a corner and everything dies, you know. Lazy play. Also, I'm playing with one button. I'm just right clicking the totems. Corrupted blood jewel, we take it. This sell very good, you will see at the end. You put your totems near the strong box, you go back and you shoot. Very easy gameplay. Some of these strong boxes explode, that's the reason I go back. Or detonate the corpses, you know? Ah, that's a rare beast. Also, it's empowered by wisps, but no problem. Usually, these are very hard to kill, you know, but... You know, when you have a good build, you don't worry. As you can see, this build is also very tanky, look. And these have tripled wisps. Look, these are just with wisps, with delirium. These monsters have delirium. Have 3 layers of wisps. And I'm still tanky, look, I'm in the middle of them. Yeah, I love this build. Good damage, good times. And very tanky. For the build again, you go on my channel, you watch for the latest videos, because I explain everything. I will take these gloves. Okay, delirium will end. Let's pick the rewards. Shit rewards. Oh, we make money. We made big money, boys. This is, from experience, I'm gonna tell you, this is perfect quantity and 10% movement speed. We made money. Boys, we made, this is great for the video. This is extremely expensive. So, this is very expensive. This is more than 25 divine orbs. So, this shows that you can make a lot of profit with Vault Temples, and I explain you that you get multiple. This is good. So this is from 25 Divine Orbs, 35 Divine Orbs, you see, with one click. This is great for the video. So you can see what to expect. Again, in 2 days I started farming this and I made around 50-60 Divine Orbs. This shows that you can get jackpot drops like this. And this is not even double corrupted, you know? Yeah. So my advice to you, like a friend, I'm telling you, if you want to make money, run these Vault Temple maps. You can also, if you like the Wisp mechanic, you can still do it. And the best part of all, this is a wandering path setup, so you get a lot of item quantity. Yeah, bye boys, buy Vault Temple maps and you listen to POE guy, and you'll make a lot of money, you know, stop being poor, you know. Make a good build, you can run it with Siege Ballista. Okay boys, look here. So here it's the Vault Temple guide that I'll put in the description. But if you don't have money, because I get it, some of you don't have money for a Shrapnel Ballista, you go on playlist on my stupid ass channel and you have here solid and fun builds. And you do the first builds from the list. So this build is similar to this one, but on a budget. You can make this build for 5 Divine Orbs and will melt Vault Temples without any problem. You can skip the League mechanic, but you'll still get this great loot. Yeah, I want to help you. So do that Siege Ballista, it's very cheap. This is more expensive, more advanced version. You gather currency with Siege Ballista and then you transition to this build, which is on a whole new level. But no problem, both builds are great, you know. They're also fun to play, you know. I'm having fun, you know. If you die every 2 seconds, it's not a good build. You're not having fun, you know. Yeah. Okay, let's check the ritual. We have here some ancient orbs, we're gonna take them. Yeah, I'm gonna defer this. I'm gonna take this and we continue. Let's see here. No. Yeah, I'm happy. This is a good way to end the video. You see, out of nowhere, you will get from time to time, like every 10 maps or so, you will get some jackpot drops that are worth more than 5 divine orbs. And this will happen pretty often. Also, because these are corrupted, you will get a lot of sixlings, you know, but I don't have space in my inventory for them, so I'll skip them. Okay, now I want to show something else. So we made
I'll put the boots for 27 Divine Orbs because these boots tend to sell very good after 2 weeks. So they will start selling very good. So let's put these 27 Divines. I'm glad I got this on video. One moment. Okay, let me sell this. This I will use for leveling, so I have here a leveling tab. I will save it because I will level Raider for my Immortal Magic Finder build. Now, let's price check this one with Corrupted Blood, because I told you this can be very expensive also. This one is shit. Nothing special. But shit, you can sell it for 20 Chaos Orb if you want. Some of them, some of you like, these are, I will tell you, this is 70 Chaos Orb, because I already price checked them. Yeah, this is around 70 Chaos. This I will put. Let's put it 50. These two, because you get duplicated. This is a Storm Shroud that dropped. I will put it 70, also in Vault Temple. I put it here 70. This I will open now. This is another Corrupted Blood Jewel with int and this is looks interesting. Yeah, this looks very good. Also have strength. Yeah, this is 2.5 Divine Orbs. I'm gonna put them here. One more. 2.5 Divine Orbs. I got it in Vault Temples, by the way. Now I have Phasing, Mana and Energy Shield. This alone is good combo. With Penetration, yeah. This I'll put it for 40 Chaos Orb. I'm gonna put it here. Ice Golem, I will price check it first. No. These gloves... I don't know why I picked them up. Let me check. No, these are shit. I'll destroy. This I'm gonna open now and I'm gonna end the video. Because I'll put in the description of the video all the links that you need for the Vault Temple guide, how to set up the Atlas and to understand the synergies, and for the this build and Siege Ballista if you are poor. Okay, let's click here and see what we get. I like to read the flavor text here. Holy macaroni, what's this bullshit, boys? I got baited. That was fuck this shit, man. I'm gonna Valor this. No. Yeah, my boys. So this was all. I hope this was useful to you. Go make some money because we like money, you know? We like to have fun. Good luck.